Good afternoon and welcome to Garden City, New York for the NCAA Division II East Regional semifinal day. Our first game of the day features the number 2 seed, the Queens Knights, against the number 6 seed, the University of the Sciences Devils.
Here's Merrick for McKenzie, who wheels to the basket and gets the first shot of the game to drop. Looks to work against Madison Rowland, who gets a piece of the shot into the hands of McKenzie, and here comes the transition again. Madison with the bounce pass to Barnum, and she lays it in. And a 10-0 start for Queens. Brings a 30-second timeout from Jackie Hartzell. Here's Merrick again on the skip pass. Shot clock down to 5. McFarland, clean look for 3. Got it. Nice skip of the pass from McKenzie Rowland to McFarland. Come in for Madison Rowland, we'll have to see. Vitelli picks it up on the perimeter. Now a step back 3 from Thomas, right side. Got it, made one earlier and makes another. She doesn't need much space, does Alex Thomas. Abenizio across half court in transition. Fans out to the side. And now is the trailer, set shot 3 is good for Colleen Walsh.
Should be a very tough matchup between those two. A
couple of chances for Queens, and Bonin makes the catch in the air and finishes in the same act. Coming up court. Quickly into the paint, tosses the floater up and gets the bounce to go. A burst from Beth Bowman. She's got 18.
A very high basketball IQ, very positionally sound, and they've been excellent in the CACC and making a name for themselves.
Off a double down screen, Emma Maloney rattles home the 3. Trish all alone in transition. Has to pull up and wait for some help. Here's Thomas as the trailer. Launches the 3 and knocks it in. First 3 of the half for Alex Thomas.
She got that ball. She was already essentially getting the pass away to Madison for the easy bucket.
Same situation there. It leads to an open 3 from Mann, who buries it from the corner. 77-67 is the final score. The Knights survive and advance, and they eliminate the University of the Sciences Devils.
Coach, a big win for your team. It seemed like every time Sciences started to make a little pushback, your team answered with a big bucket, especially Madison Rowland. Tell me about the mental resolve of your team in those situations.
You know, both Madison and McKenzie shoot the ball at over 50% from the field. So we felt as long as they were going to take 2s that we could match those 2s. So once we got that lead, we were going to kind of allow some of those 2s go because we felt we could match it on the other end. So, you know, Madison is obviously a huge part of what we do, and she reads the game very well, and she shoots the ball very well. So she stepped up. She did a great job, as usual.
Now, Madison and McKenzie, you mentioned both in their final year here. Is there more of a sense of urgency from you and the team to try to get something done, try to get out of the region for them in their last year here?
I don't know if there's a sense of urgency, but there's a sense that we certainly owe them for what they've done in our program for 4 years. So it's definitely a full team commitment to reaching this goal. We hope we can get one more. But we definitely want Madison and McKenzie and Joya to go out having a great senior year because they've done a lot for our program.
Now, it seemed like you guys really were getting out on the perimeter, defending their 3s very closely. I think that helped limit them in this game. Tell me about your defensive strategy, knowing this team comes in shooting a lot of 3s.
That's exactly what it was. We felt like we can get up and deny that 3, and we felt like we were quick enough that we can also defend the back door at the same time against USciences. So when they started to go backdoor, we were able to stay with it. I thought we were able to follow that game plan very well. Again, we felt like as long as they were taking 2s, then it would be a game that would go in our favor.
And now coming up, the winner of Molloy and Adelphi, those teams squaring off next. Obviously, Molloy you know very well, and Adelphi another team that's been very good in the region, very good on this floor, their home floor. I'm not saying you have a preference, but obviously you're looking at a tough fight either way.
Definitely. Molloy dealt us our only regular season loss, so we certainly know that they are a quality and capable team. And again, anyone who's at the tournament at this point is certainly capable. And Adelphi, we've been 1-2 all year long in this is each region. So no matter who we face, we know it's going to be a hotly contested game.
All right, Coach, thanks so much. Go enjoy this win, and we'll see you on Monday.
Thank you very much. Thank you.